Today in Across the Fence, art and agriculture. We'll learn about a unique dance project that celebrates Vermont's farming culture and expands the audience for classical ballet. Good afternoon and thanks for joining us. I'm Judy Simpson. It was Shakespeare who wrote "All the World's a Stage." Well, this summer, Vermont Farms will be center stage for the second season of the Farm to Ballet project. Farm to Ballet tells the story of a Vermont farming operation from spring through fall. There will be 9 performances on farm venues throughout the state, and they include original composition linking farmers and food production to music and dance. Joining me are 2 dancers in the Farm to Ballet project. I want to welcome Katie Decker and Maria Mersica. Thanks so much for coming in. This sounds like such a great project.
Thanks for having us.
Now, it's a unique concept, but a perfect way to highlight our beautiful landscape. What was the motivation, Katie, for bringing ballet to the farm?
Yeah, it is a unique concept. I think that a lot of the motivation just came from combining a lot of the things that we love about Vermont. I don't know if people know that there's such a vibrant adult dance community. A lot of the people who are a part of this dance project are adults who are professionals locally doing different jobs, but they dance within their spare time. And so there's these big classes of lots of dancers that have formed this community. And so that was one thing, was really wanting to celebrate and honor that community and let people know, hey, if you're an adult and you used to dance or you want to dance again, you can come back and join this community. So that was one thing. And then the other thing was really just trying to honor Vermont and the outdoors, the beautiful outdoors, and to dance outside in the summer. And to do that through honoring the agricultural culture that we have going on in Vermont. So combining all those things that we love into one project has been pretty awesome.
And so whose idea was this?
I would say it was artistic director Josh Preger's idea. I think he got the idea. He likes to talk about his farm share pickup and that being one of his favorite days of the week. And so we try when we're dancing ballet, we try to figure out how we can get outside because the summer's so short in Vermont. And
right,
so,
true.
So we had an outdoor ballet class and then we sort of started combining all those ideas. And that's how the Farm to Ballet project came to be.
And how did you get involved, Maria?
Well, when I first heard about Farm to Ballet, I was really excited about the idea of taking class again. I'm 40, I'm a mother of 2, and I never imagined I'd be able to perform classical ballet again at this stage in my life. So I went back to class, and at that point, I talked to Katie about the company a little bit, and I took it from there.
And so, as you mentioned, Farm to Ballet is the brainchild of Josh Preger. He was the founder and the director and a native of New Haven. So let's hear from him about why he took on the Farm to Ballet project.
So we wanted to dance outside. We wanted to dance classical repertoire. So I kind of had the idea to make it a mashup, to take that repertoire and tell a new story with it. Once those two ideas came together, that we can dance outside, we can dance classical ballet, we can tell a new story, we have a new audience. Maybe farmers would be interested in that. Maybe people who are interested in food would be interested in that. And I think through that idea, it kind of went from a little niche thing that we might decide to do to something that people might actually want to come watch.
So Farm to Ballet is heading into its second summer. Tell me a little bit about the performance itself.
Well, it's like you mentioned, it follows a farmer on her farm from spring to fall, and it's just about her daily life on the farm. It's a little bit over an hour long. It's great for kids. There's animals in it. There's, you know, it's outside. You can see live animals if you look to the left. You can see dancing animals, and it's a really fun experience.
So who are some of the performers?
Well, with the exception of 1 9-year-old boy, we, like Katie mentioned, we're an adult dance company. Our youngest member is 17, our oldest member is 73.
Wow.
Yeah, so we have a really wide range in ages as well as experience. Some of us have been dancing our whole lives, some of us have only been dancing a few years. So it's a lot of variety in the company.
So how long have each of you been dancing, Maria? Why don't you start and tell me a little bit about your story?
Sure. Well, I grew up as a dancer. I was training professionally with Joffrey Ballet School and at North Carolina School of the Arts, but I was under a lot of pressure to lose weight. And eventually I just ended up calling it quits when I was about 15. I didn't really dance again at all until I moved to Vermont in my late 20s and I started doing musical theater. Like I said, when I heard about Farm to Ballet, that really motivated me to go back to class.
And how about for you, Katie?
Well, different story completely. I started ballet a little over 3 years ago.
So no kidding.
As an adult, I definitely danced whenever I was younger. I also did musical theater whenever I was younger, but didn't at all through college or as an adult. And then as an adult, was really looking for a new community and like a new way to spend my time. And so I took a dance class or two and then really got connected to this particular ballet, I think, in particular, because it was an opportunity to exercise, move your body for sure, but there was an opportunity to really improve your technique and learn.
Right.
And once I started to see that that was possible, it was really motivating for me, and I started taking a lot of classes and didn't even realize that there was already this whole group of adults who were in similar positions. Some had danced their whole lives, some of them were just starting, and it's an awesome community.
Yeah, and what's really great about Chach is that even though you're an adult and you're not going to be a professional ballerina in New York City Ballet at this point, but he treats you like a student and he really focuses on your technique and wants you to improve and gives you a lot of corrections, and I really appreciate that. And really this experience has been kind of like a dream for me to be able to perform again.
That's wonderful. Tell me a little bit about your roles in the ballet.
The roles that we're dancing? Mm-hmm. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
So I'm a lettuce. Well, you didn't think that was coming, did you?
Well, that's a great thing to have on your resume.
I'm a naughty tomato. I'm a bee. I'm a tree. Those are some of the roles that I play.
Yeah. Well, we're both demi-solos, so we both have pretty much the same roles. But you're also a cow, aren't you?
No, I'm not a cow. Not this year.
So how often do you rehearse?
Well, right now we're rehearsing twice a week inside of the studio. We just added what we call a patch of grass rehearsals, which give us a chance to get outside and perform on the grass, because it's definitely a big transition going from like traditional dance floors to outdoors.
Right. I mean, don't you worry about safety?
We do.
You could turn an ankle. I mean, you could fall?
Yeah. I mean, the choreography has been adjusted. We're not doing as many turns. We're doing more leaps. Mm-hmm. But so far, we haven't had any injuries from doing that. I mean, we're really trying to pay attention to precise technique anyway. That's part of ballet. And so really trying to pay attention to where you're putting your body at any given time. So we're just doing that with the grass now.
Mm-hmm. And so what are some of the challenges?
Of dancing on the grass?
Yeah.
Well, the grass is all different. You start to like really pay attention to the nuances of the earth. You know, we had a venue last year.
That probably helps in your role as lettuce.
Yeah, exactly. We had this venue last year, which was so awesome. Like where they chose to put it on the farm was, it was out in Barnard, and it was sort of out in a cow pasture that they'd mowed down for us. And the audience was able to sit on this hill, and then the hill came back up, and we were performing on the top of the hill. So it was this beautiful sort of setup, but it was a cow pasture, and so the grass was really rough, and we were raking, you know, the area. We had this joke of like, do we leave the cow patties? Do we move the cow patties?
How authentic should this be?
Should we dance on them? Should we move them? But yeah, I guess those are some of the challenges. But it really connects us to the whole point of the project, which is really like, outside.
Yeah, what must that be like performing outside on a farm with this beautiful backdrop?
Exactly what it sounds like. Amazing.
It is. It's beautiful. It's a really, if you spend a lot of time dancing and then you get to dance outside and you love being outside, it really sort of brings together all those things that you love. It's pretty fulfilling.
Now, as dancers, I understand you're also involved in the marketing setup and just about every aspect of the shows.
Yeah, this is the second year that we've done this, and last year was pretty much done entirely by volunteers. So we're able to, because people are so committed and motivated around the project, we are able to capitalize on all the different strengths that the dancers and the people who are part of the planning committee have, because they're all working professionals in the world, right? So they have all these different skills that they're able, and connections that they're able to bring to the project. And it's through those skills and those volunteering that those who are volunteering that make the whole production happen.
So there's no road crew. You are the road crew.
We are the road crew. We are the ones moving the cow patties or leaving them there. That's us.
Well, at least you get to make those decisions.
Yeah, that's true.
So the shows also serve as a fundraiser for not-for-profit organizations. How does that work?
Yeah, that's one of the other unique parts of the project is how we've sort of created this structure. So we, the planning team and the dancers, do all the fundraising to put on the production. So we write grants, we do fundraising, we sell ads for our playbill, and all that money allows us to put on the production. Then we're able to say, here's our production, and we're able to offer it to farms and to different nonprofits to say, hey, we want to honor the work that you're doing, we want to further the work that you're doing, so how can we be of service to you? And therefore, then the venues and the nonprofits are able to host our show, and the ticket sales then go to expanding their farm, to whatever the work is that the nonprofit's doing, and so it's sort of our way of sort of having this cycle where we get to bring our ballet to places in Vermont maybe that don't have access readily to ballet, and they're able to sort of use that as a vehicle and a means to further the work that they're doing in the agricultural field. So
if you're just joining us, we're discussing the Farm to Ballet project. I've been speaking with two of the dancers. Here's one of last season's audience members describing the special and unique experience of going to this ballet.
The story being told through the dancers' bodies and through the motions and the story told through the seasons, this is just a really special event. You can spend a lot of money to go to a play in New York City and it's not going to do this.
Wow, is that pretty typical response that you get from folks who see the show?
Yeah. One of the things that did surprise us last year, that I guess if we thought about it, maybe we should have expected, was how family-centered the event was, what it means to be able to take your kid to a ballet and not have to stress out about what their experience is going to be, because they can literally dance wherever they want. They
right.
can move
it's
their
like,
bodies.
Shh, sit down, be quiet, don't bother
back. No, not at all. So that's been something that's been really awesome about it. And also, kids are very interested in ballet, you know, like, but they don't always have the opportunity to see it besides maybe the Nutcracker. And so this is a really great opportunity for kids to see dance in a setting that is perfect. Perfect for a kid.
Yeah, I completely agree with that. I have two little girls, and I took my older one to see the Nutcracker this year, and the whole time I was just so stressed about, like, we have to be really quiet. And, you know, it's great that parents can expose their kids to this type of culture without having to worry about that at all. They can just, you know, dance and run and be themselves and experience ballet.
Right, ballet is fun.
Right.
Yeah, we think so.
Well, let's take a moment to hear from Megan Stearns. Megan dances the lead role of the farmer.
You know, it's a story ballet, and I think there are things in it that kids will love, but there's also a lot in it that dance aficionados will love. There's really something for everybody.
Oh, that's something that looks like a lot of fun, just running around in the fields.
Yeah.
So this is your second year,
mm-hmm.
and this is your first year.
Correct.
And so what are your thoughts so far?
I am just absolutely loving the experience. I love being part of the community and being in the middle of a group of dancers again. And it's just been absolutely wonderful for me. It really
now,
has.
So where are these performances taking place this summer?
They're all throughout Vermont. We're reaching 6 different counties this year, which is great. And they're at different farms. You can find out on our website all the different locations. We really are trying to get out there and get around Vermont as
right.
much as we can. So
yeah, we're in some performances in Chittenden County and Shelburne and Williston, Charlotte, but we're also going to some places I've never been before, like Brattleboro, mm-hmm. Woodstock, and a lot of different towns.
Poultney, New Haven, Hinesburg.
Mm-hmm.
It's
yeah.
a great schedule. So how can people buy tickets and how much do they cost?
You can buy tickets by going to our website, which is farmtoballet.org. There's a nice layout there because all the different shows are, the ballet is the same, but the experience at the venue is different. We really want people to spend some time on the farm. There's going to be food, different food options at the different farms, different educational opportunities. And so you can go to the website, look at the different experiences that you could have. The tickets are $15 for adults, but kids 12 and under are free.
Well, that's fantastic.
Yeah,
right.
I want to thank you both for joining us today. We're going to wrap up today's program with a scene from the inaugural season of Farm to Ballet. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Judy Simpson. We'll see you again next time on Across the Fence.